right outcome that you don't see as government taking from what I see, you think that it's more of you.
Okay, there is something that I would want you to follow up. Maybe you can check in the public. There was a conversation that happened during His Excellency's tenure concerning also the other beneficiaries of the Office of the Retired President. And there is actually a conversation that happened between State House and the AG's office. I'm just not able to have those documents right now, but it alluded to the fact that being able to rent an office that belongs or is related to the family was not a conflict in interest issue. That issue was raised with one of the former retired, or one of the beneficiaries, I'm just not able to name who it is right now, but it was concluded by the AG then that is not a conflict of interest, and that's why the former president made the decision to have the offices here. Yes. Yes. Yes.
My question is, the reason why the settlement is actually structured on the office of the retired president.
Yes. Benefits Act, yes.
Don't you think there are fewer terms and conditions that come to these benefits that perhaps the government feels have been flouted or are not being adhered to, especially touching politics that could bring this complexity and give them a good grey area not to do what you're asking them to do?
I know that one of the things that they talk about is his involvement in politics. And I think the correct position is that if you remember very clearly, immediately after inauguration, there was an NDC that was held by the Jubilee Party. And the process of that, the purpose of that NDC was to begin a process for him to be able to hand over chairmanship. But as we know, things went as they went, and the matter is currently in court. So, inevitably, he remains the chairman of Jubilee. Inevitably, because he's one of the key, the Jubilee is one of the key parties of Azimio, he still remains in Jubilee. However, I think we can note anywhere that he has been inactive in terms of political activity. So I don't think that that should be a basis or a TOR that should necessitate the kind of treatment that the office of the retired third president is receiving.
And finally, the level of the former president and the level of the current president, the difference is former and current.
Yes.
Has there been attempts directly by the former president to speak to the current president with the view of certain of his administrative issues on its exclusively to the office of the administrator?
I think there's nothing that has necessitated there to be a conversation, because everything is, it's a rule of law. It's how things need to happen. It's the operations that would require for them to have a conversation. Yes.
I just wanted to know, how desperate is the situation? How desperate are you? Because 2 years ago, the salary...
Well, we thank God for his mercies. That's not where we are at right now. But actually, it's not fair. Let's just say that it's not fair for us to have waited for 2 years and going, and we still don't have an idea when that's going to end.
Hivi msimamo wa ofisi ya rais wa nne wa taifa la Kenya ni gani? Hivi huenda tukamwona labda Uhuru kama hayo, hilo la kwanza. Kisha la pili, nitaomba utupe muhtasari cha kitabu cha Kiswahili wapo chakulani mwishoni mwa kipindi hiki cha maswali na majibu.
Kuhusiana na suala hilo la siasa, nadhani ameshaweka wazi na umeona kwamba katika matendo yake kwamba hajajihusisha vyovyote vile na siasa. Watu kumtaja, wangependa kumtaja, kuna mapendekezo, na ni mapendekezo tu yako humu ambayo hayana uhakika wowote. Kwa hivyo sidhani kama itakuwa ni sawa kuweza kumuunganisha na masuala haya, manake yeye mwenyewe hajasimama akaweza kuyataja kama mambo ambayo yanahusika nayo. Wamekuwa wanapigiwa simu usiku na wanaambiwa waende katika station tofauti kuliko ile ambayo wameletwa hapa. Yaani wanapigwa transfer kupitia simu. Wapo. Lakini kwa sababu pia wao ni wa maafisa wa serikali, tungependa kuwalinda. Yes, Mushoki.
The former CJ, yes, Mara Kumpindo, the same thing.